The bees are in trouble, but we can all help them survive by using the helpful tips in this video. Hi everyone, my name is Kaylee Lemoyne, video producer here at Hostas Direct. We are very concerned with all environmental issues and want to help in any way that we can. I had the opportunity to visit with a customer of ours, JoAnne Sabin, who amongst other things is a beekeeper, speaker, and beekeeping instructor. Coming up is a special story on bees, why they are disappearing, why helping them survive is important to all of us, and what we can all do to help.
So we just don't need to be as afraid of bees as we really are. Bees are actually gentle and beneficial, and we need to be nice to the bees because the bees are in trouble. There are a lot of people have heard in the news about colony collapse disorder, CCD, and this showed up in the mid-2000s where commercial beekeepers, several of them in the same year, discovered that their hives were perfectly healthy one day and they came back for the next inspection a week later. And there weren't dead bees, there were no bees. That's what colony collapse disorder is. And disorder just means we don't really know what it is. It's unusual for the bees to all disappear. If there's been, you know, some incident, then there will be dead bees usually in front of the hive. Usually if there's a pesticide killing, there'll be dead bees in front of the hive. The hive will decline slowly if there's a disease or a parasite, which there are diseases and parasites that are killing bees as well. But they kill the hive slowly, so the colony collapse is this big mystery. Other bees, if they see an unattended hive, hey, free honey in here, and they'll come get it. But in the colony collapse hives, other bees won't even go in and rob the totally undefended honey. And when they did tests inside those hives, they couldn't test any dead bees because there were no dead bees, but they found a multitude of diseases in those hives, more than we even knew existed. Bees are beneficial because they pollinate. That's actually the best product that they do for us. When we eat our food, a lot of that food is the result of an insect pollinating that plant. And so plants and bees evolve together. The plant attracts the bee with the nectar and the pollen, and the bee gathers it and helps the plant by pollinating it, by helping it reproduce. And if a vegetable or a fruit didn't get pollinated, then we wouldn't have the fruit or the vegetable, or we'd have a fruit or vegetable that's undeveloped or immature or just really not as much of it. So we can thank a bee for every third bite that we eat, not only because of the food that they directly pollinate, but also because of the food that they pollinate that then indirectly helps feed other things that we eat, like livestock. Eat alfalfa, and alfalfa is pollinated by bees. That's the main benefit, is their pollination. We still have not found any single cause of colony collapse disorder. It's probably a combination of things. Probably poor nutrition, lack of habitat. So we're, you know, all the native, all the feral bees, the wild bees, they have no place to live anymore because we pave everything. We have these big, huge lawns that they can't live in. The other thing that's probably a contributing factor is the diseases and the parasites, and one parasite in particular, the varroa destructor mite, apt name. and they feed on the developing bees and weaken them, make them more susceptible to diseases and also vector diseases. And so that weakens the hive in general. But the last piece of the puzzle is probably pesticides. And we tend to use pesticides more quickly than we need to. And we don't always use them correctly. And there's two different kinds of pesticides. A new pesticide that just came on the market and started being widely used around about the time colony collapse. So there are a number of beekeepers that suspect there's a correlation there. So they're trying to do more testing to find out, you know, their role. But this new class of pesticides are systemic. They're called neonicotinoids. And the neonicotinoids They are taken up into the whole plant. So when a pest bug comes and chews on the plant, it will die because it gets the insecticide on that leaf, even though you didn't put the insecticide on that leaf. It's in the whole plant. So what this means for the bees is that the insecticide is actually in the nectar and pollen of the treated plant. Well, the bees will bring that back to their hive, the pollen and nectar, and they'll feed it to their young, and they'll eat it themselves. And that what that does is continuously expose the entire colony to the pesticide. And this is true not only for honeybees, but also for all the native bees. What's going on right now is many independent research studies seem to indicate that this has several detrimental sublethal effects on the honeybees, you know, as well as the native bees, things that would lead to their decline. If we want to help the bees, so a couple of things. Provide habitat, be a beekeeper. And I know that's not for everybody, but provide food for them. Now the bees need to eat from spring all the way through fall. And if we have just one kind of flower, well, if we have no flowers in our yard, okay, there's nothing for them to eat. So, you know, maybe take some of that grass and make an extra garden and give them a variety of plants, because, you know, the bees only get food from the plant when it's blooming. And so when one thing is done blooming and there's nothing else blooming, then they've got nothing to eat. So we want to have a variety of plants, some that bloom in early spring, early summer, midsummer, all the way through the season, all the way up until fall. And especially early spring and late fall, it's troublesome for the bees, because we usually plant things that bloom in the middle of summer when we like it. But hostas, bees like hosta flowers, so you know, that's they're a good thing to plant for shady gardens along with other things. But bees tend to like purple flowers. The one that we saw earlier that had a lot of bees on it, they like that one. That's a salvia. If it's a plant that butterflies and hummingbirds like, that means it's got a lot of nectar in it, and its chances are that the bees will like it. Another benefit is the honey that they make, and we love honey. It tastes wonderful. It's fabulous to cook with, and it's more nutritious as a sweetener than just plain sugar. And it's also got some healing properties that a lot of people don't know about. So wounds and burns actually can heal better and faster when you dress them with honey. Spread the word that people don't need to be as afraid of bees, you know, that there's a difference between bees and wasps. Bees are much more docile, much more friendly, much less likely to sting, especially honeybees, who will die if they sting, so they don't want to. And last resort is chemicals and pesticides. There's a lot of manual things we can do that are less invasive, less destructive to the environment.
Colony collapse disorder, or CCD, is just part of the problems plaguing bees. We have provided additional information about other things killing bees and how you can help at the links in the description below. No matter where you buy your plants from, we hope you expand your gardens with flowering plants for bees, butterflies, birds, and the environment in general. Thanks for watching.